Ms. Weeks, do you know Carlenia Ivory?
Oh, yeah.
I know that face, how we know.
Oh, honey, you need to know her. Okay, I'm gonna let her, with your permission, let Carlenia talk a little bit about stuff that's happening in the West Boulevard area, because she started, well, she worked with Dr. Waddy over there. Go ahead.
Okay, she just asked me to do this, so I really don't know where to start. But I work with the school system, and you know, I'm trying to go along the corridor and see some of the things that we're doing. We're doing a lot of work with West Meck Sherry's involved with West Meck, but right now we're really trying to work with the families and the children in that area. We've had several meetings. Delva Byer Bailey has been over there lately. She talked with them. It was a room full of parents regarding the school assignment. But right now, we're working on a plan to work with like 21 students. And believe me, with the students that we're working with, who there's a lot of challenges, and 21 parents. And so we're planning our next meeting with the students is on May 9th, and this is very appropriate because I'm looking for 9-10 strong facilitators to come in for about an hour just to meet with the students, and we're going to invite the parents just to be observers, just to meet with the students for encouragement. Because what we have found in a lot of the situations that the students are there in an environment, but when they go home, they're in an environment that is similar to what they have at school. They bring the issues to school, but they go home and those same issues. What we have found in just listening, because we haven't built relationships yet, and that's what we're trying to do with the parents, one-on-one, is to build a relationship so we can tell the parent, you know, you're in denial. Because what we have found is, if a student, and I heard this, told the parent, I want to be a doctor. And the parent's response, you're not going to be no doctor, you're not going to be anything, da 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 da. Well, how do you think that student feels? And they probably, with 3 credits, they probably might not be a doctor, but at least there could be some encouragement from home, because they could be a physician assistant. They could be a doctor, who knows? But anyway, we have found that working with the parents, it's children raising children. And so we're working very hard, and we need support for the students at West Meck. Those students want to be at school. They come to school, maybe to get away from the environment at home. It's what they do once they get there. And that's just at West Meck. There are resources that are needed throughout that West Boulevard corridor. Reed Park. I know that there are people going over there to constantly read. They need summer camp. We have someone working on giving us funding for summer camp. We have, family night scheduled this Thursday at Southfield. Parents and kids come out. They just need something positive to do, and they need to see positive role models. And they just need to see people who care and encourage them. One thing that I observed with the 21 students that we're working with, I have heard them use all type of language. I've seen them on their phones, and I wanted to take the phones and throw them away, but it's because of being here at Tuesday morning and listening to people like Charles and things. You have to change your mentality when you're working with young people, as hard as it is. And since I've done a little bit of that, and I've heard some of the young people that you guys have had on the Tuesday morning forum, and you have a different approach with them, it's yes ma'am, no ma'am. I don't know what they do when they leave me, but they do have respect. They learn that respect. So anyway, I could go on and on, and if I, you know, had known that I was going to do this, I could have told you more of what we're doing. We're working with Faith. We have a Faith Summit coming up on May 3rd at Discovery Place from 9 until noon. We've extended the invitation to 200 plus ministers. We have 57 registered. 57. So if you, you know, go to church and you have a minister, please let me know. Go to church and have a minister. So please let me know. We would love to extend that invitation because, as we all know, with her having been here last week or 2 weeks, we need the ministers engaged and involved. It's not that our department or people within the school system that we're not trying. We want to have collaboration with the community. I listened to about C.W. Williams. There's so many kids who we know that the root of the situation is the social and emotional development. We have a young man, Dr. Kendall Jasper, who is their age, coming in, and it's amazing how they're able to relate to him. He's not sanctioned by CMS, but he's one of the best that there is, and we're trying to work on getting him sanctioned. We need to make sure we partner and we do fairs with C.W. Williams. They're right there in that corridor. They surround that corridor, you know, all those schools. So, yes, we all need to do a better job. You're welcome to come to the Faith Summit, and whether you're church or not, just to let us know how can we work together, how can we move forward, because we're looking for partners. There's a lot of challenges.
Thank you, Carlene. This is the reason, that's the reason we are here. We've been doing this for a long, long time, and I keep saying, you know, Rome was not built in a day, but we have to keep doing it. And you know, things are going to get better. They'll get worse again, but they'll get better again. So we need to just keep. No, we are not going to give up. Thank you, Carlenia. Okay,
I did my best.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
Let's.
Can I say one other thing? We had a meeting the other day at Mount Carmel. And basically, it was to invite the faith community. We had two ministers to show up, but we had some community. Thank you, Dr. Faloki. Thank you, I'm looking at it, Queen Coxon, for coming, because they were there. And I think that, we'll start doing some things together with community help. So thank you guys for coming.